Hello, and welcome to the expert session on why digital marketing analytics. We're going to go through an overview of digital marketing analytics and then talk through a case study of why you should study digital marketing analytics and how you can leverage it in your career. So, my name is Nathan David, and I'm the founder and lead consultant at Meta Impact. Meta Impact is a digital marketing and business analytics consultancy. I also am a teacher and I am an adjunct instructor at Marquette University. So I'm excited to share with you a topic I'm very passionate about, which is digital marketing analytics. So let's dive into it. Digital marketing analytics. Why is it so important? So a lot of people are familiar with digital marketing and things like social media and search engines and why they're important to businesses. But I really am passionate about the analytics, the data behind digital marketing. Why? Because digital marketing analytics is the language that people use in business to talk about digital marketing. So it is the thing that connects all tactics within digital marketing. Whether you're a paid search advertiser, you're an email marketer, you're a community manager on a social media platform, you need to understand digital marketing analytics because you need to be able to talk about the results, the audience that you're reaching on those different platforms, as well as collaborate with your other coworkers and weave a larger story about how the enterprise is using digital marketing as a whole. And digital marketing analytics enables you to do that. It enables all these different players to speak the same language. And I want to make sure that individuals know this language so that when they get into business, they can not just be a one-trick pony. They can have conversations across a lot of different areas of digital marketing and really expand their influence. So, without further ado, let's get into what is digital marketing analytics. This is a framework that I built, and the framework outlines what digital marketing analytics is. There's four main components. And let's start on the far left side. Digital marketing analytics inputs. These basically answer the question, where does the data come from that you analyze when you're looking at digital marketing analytics? So the data comes from three main places. It comes from consumers, and specifically, what are their needs? So marketing fundamentally is creating value to address consumer needs. So when consumers have needs, they go out onto the internet, they go out and interact with digital marketing platforms. And through those interactions, they're creating data that us as digital marketing analysts can look at, review, and analyze. Also, companies are creating a lot of data through their digital marketing. So your company that you work for is out there posting on social media. It has a website, so it's creating a lot of data. But so are competitors. Your competitors are doing those same sort of tactics, and you can look at the data that they're contributing to digital marketing analytics as well. And finally, governments contribute. They provide public data sources, but more importantly, they have different regulations on data privacy. And those basically are the roadblocks and walls of what data you can collect and how you can use the data that you collect. So that's very important to understand as well. So those inputs are, how do we get the data that we're analyzing? Next, let's talk about digital marketing media. So this is what we think about when we think about digital marketing. Digital marketing media involves all those different platforms that you think of when you think of digital marketing, like Facebook, like Google, like Bing, like a mobile app, like an email account. So all these different interaction points that the businesses have with consumers, those happen through digital marketing media. And to help, break down this huge swath of different platforms, there's three main buckets that we look at: owned media, paid media, and earned media. So let's talk through those right now. Owned media. So, owned digital marketing analytics is analytics that's for owned media, like your website, like a mobile app your company has, your email programs, the videos you have, and also owned social media accounts. So your Facebook page that you own and manage, your Twitter account, your Instagram account, your TikTok account, and other owned social media accounts. So what do these all have in common? You, the analyst, or your business has control over these. You control the messaging, you control what goes out on your own platforms, and you control how those look. So that is one area of digital marketing. The next is paid digital marketing. And so analytics on these platforms are rather robust because basically what you're doing with paid media is you're going out and you're renting space from someone else that has eyeballs. So there's a lot of consumers, for example, who go to Google search. So you can do paid media through Google search and have paid search ads show up in front of those individuals. So you're renting some real estate from Google. So what sorts of platforms fall into paid digital marketing? Search ad platforms like Google, like Bing, display ad platforms, paid social, affiliate and influencer, as well as e-commerce platforms like Amazon has a lot of robust paid options where you can pay to get your product higher up in rankings and in front of consumers. So all these different players like Google, like Amazon that are selling real estate provide really robust data and analytics because they want you as a marketer to come back to them over and over again because if you do, you spend more money with them, they make more revenue. So they give you lots of data on how your ads are performing and if your paid advertising is actually being impactful. Finally, we have earned media. So earned media and digital marketing analytics for earned media revolves around these areas. Social listening. So this is you're putting your ear to the ground and you're hearing what people are saying on social media. Search listening. You're putting your ear to the ground and you're hearing what people are searching for on Google, Bing, and other search platforms. Digital PR, which is the digital version of public relations. External links, so people linking from one site to another, in ratings and reviews, which a lot of people refer to when they're evaluating a product or a business, they go and they look up the star rating or they look up what other consumers have said. So what do all these have in common with one another? Earned media is media that you cannot directly control. And you're putting the control fully in the hands of third parties. So you can't control if 100 people on Facebook mention your brand. You can't control if those mentions are positive or negative or neutral. And so earned media of all these different buckets is the hardest to measure, but there's still data out there that you can dive into and look into as an analyst. So this is a critical part of digital marketing media as well. So we've talked about the data inputs. We've talked about the media itself. Now let's talk about you, the student, or what I'll call you is the analyst. So an analyst is the job role that I define as someone who works in digital marketing analytics. And you, as an analyst, you go through what I call the decision-making framework. Each time you have to do an analysis of digital marketing data. You start with a question, then you curate data, you analyze that data, and finally you optimize. So this is an iterative process that you, the analyst, will go through. The question comes from your business. What is your business priorities? What are their business objectives? What are their goals? So maybe a simple question could be something like, how do we increase sessions to our website or visits to our website. Okay, let me curate data. So let me collect data about our website, maybe from Google Analytics, and see what the trends are and what different media is driving traffic to our website. Then let's do the analysis and look at those different components and really see what levers do we have that we can pull. What investments can we make to increase the total amount of visits to our website? Then finally, the most important step is optimize. So once you have insights from that analysis, you have to make optimizations and recommendations. If you, as an analyst, have control of something, you should make that change. So if you have control over the paid search campaigns and you find out, oh, we're targeting foreign countries and we should only be targeting our native country, then make that modification. But if you can't make the change, you have to make a recommendation. So you have to tell a persuasive story of, okay, this is what I found out, and tell your manager, tell your leadership, these are the changes that we need to make. The final component of the framework is your company. So this iterative decision-making process that you're going through, where you're questioning and then ultimately optimizing. So you're creating optimizations and recommendations that impact your company. So you go to your company and you say, let's make these changes, or I made these changes to improve results. So your company has this sort of dialect that I call the measurement model, which is what they find important. What are their business objectives? Is it to drive profits? Is it to reach more people and gain awareness? And then there's goals under those. So if it's to reach more individuals, maybe one of the goals is to increase web traffic by 10% next month. And then under that, you can provide insights and what are the key performance indicators and what is the data telling you and what modifications should we make. So the final result of all this digital marketing analytics work is measurable results, results that can be measured, not hypothetical, not I think that this made a difference. It's actual results that you can tie back to the different decisions that you made. And that's digital marketing analytics. And as an analyst, your job is to distill those optimizations and those recommendations to drive results. So let's talk about a case study. I've said why digital marketing analytics is important, but I think it's more impactful to show you how it can really transform a career. So let's start at the beginning of our case study story with right out of college, Nathan. So yes, this case study is about me, but I think it's a great way for you to understand how digital marketing analytics can really transform your career. So this is me right out of college, and I went to the University of Dayton. And just like you, you're currently taking a digital marketing analytics or a digital marketing course. I learned some things through a digital marketing course at the University of Dayton. I had a phenomenal instructor who's still teaching there, Irene Dickey, and I learned about digital marketing, and that's where my journey started. As I got out of college, I was fortunate enough to get a full-time position at a very large agency, which is now called Publicis Sapient. So that agency gave me lots of different opportunities and exposed me to a lot of different brands, including Fortune 500 companies. But I was at the bottom of the totem pole. I was entry level, and I did whatever needed to be done, and I learned a ton. But something I noticed right away was the people in the room that had the most influence, the people in the room who were being turned to and asked, "What do you think?" Those were the people who understood the data. They understood the data behind the different digital marketing tactics. And so I really was determined to not just be a digital marketing specialist, but a digital marketing analyst, someone who understood the data and was able to, you know, weave stories and be that reference point for the organization. So I built my expertise in data and in digital marketing, and I was able to secure from that entry-level role a role as a director of digital marketing at a small agency. And it was a phenomenal opportunity. Link Media 360, before I came there, they were focused on nothing else than physical yellow pages. So literally, many of you have probably never even seen them. A book of hundreds and hundreds of pages of business listings that would be mailed to individuals' addresses. That was like the search engine before there was Google. And so that was the marketing they were doing, and they saw that they needed to migrate to digital. And so I was the first member of their digital team, and I had the opportunity to build a team that would transition those clients who were using Yellow Pages to things like search engines and social media. And the backbone of why we were successful there is because we did analytics and reporting. And we always had monthly reporting for our clients. And I made an emphasis that every single person on my team understood analytics and was able to speak data. Because when we talked to our clients, they cared about data, they cared about numbers and the results, not just how many vanity metrics did we drive. So a vanity metric like impressions or clicks, but actually how many reservations were there? How much revenue did you drive as an agency? So that really was an amazing opportunity, and it was lended to me because of my focus on analytics. I wanted to focus in on one organization and really get deep into the weeds. So from Link Media 360, I moved to Cleveland Clinic, where I was the director of growth marketing. And growth marketing is basically anything we can do to drive people to our website. And it was great to really get down deep into the data that Cleveland Clinic had and understand, what is happening, what is driving individuals, what sort of content are people hungry for? And again, I built my influence and my expertise by being the person in the room who understood the data and was able to tell a story. By the end of the time I was there, Cleveland Clinic was receiving over 12 million unique users to their website every single month. And I was able to persuade them to shift investments from traditional marketing into digital marketing. And we were spending millions of dollars in digital marketing because, not because I was the most senior person, not because I was, good friends with leadership. It was because I had the data and I could tell a story around how we can drive more business results, more patients, or more revenue for the organization. So from there, I wanted to take that expertise and help more people. So I created my own consultancy, Meta Impact. We really specialize in data. So people come to us because they're not just looking for digital marketing, they're looking for how do we connect our digital marketing to actual business results? How do we connect digital marketing to profits? So we help people do that. But even more, what I love than working at my consultancy is working with students like you. So, as I mentioned, I'm an adjunct instructor at Marquette University, and there I'm able to, complete the circle. So I started my digital marketing analytics journey just like you are at a university in a class, and I took that and I transformed it into a career. And my goal is to help you understand this area so that you can leverage it as you see fit to enhance your own career and put you on a path that you wouldn't have been able to put yourself on without data and the power and influence that comes with understanding data. So with that, I just want to leave you by saying you can be an analyst. Anyone can be an analyst. Don't be afraid of data. Over time, as you work and you flex those muscles of using data in conducting analysis, you'll get more and more comfortable doing so. And if you become an analyst, or even if you don't go into digital marketing analytics and you're in some other completely different field, if you can incorporate data into what you do, you can become an indispensable employee, which is ultimately where you want to be because that gives you more options and more freedom to do the things you want to do in your career. Thank you so much. If you'd like to learn more about digital marketing analytics, I've partnered with Stu Kent to create a textbook on digital marketing analytics, and that has tons of resources that you can explore.